Rise from your grave.
Hello, Quakers, and welcome to another episode of the Quake Grave. You know, these map packs, these map jams, they keep coming. They don't stop, and we still got more to play even after this one. But today we're going to be taking a little bit of a backseat drive approach. We're going to be playing through the Explore Jam 2 pack. Now, this is a little bit more lighthearted than what you're used to here, because there's no fighting whatsoever. There's going to be no monsters, but there's a ton of secrets to find, so maybe that'll keep you entertained here. So I want to apologize on two fronts here. One is that I'm getting over a cold here, so if I sound a bit stuffy during this video, that is why. So I apologize for that, and I also apologize if this video comes off a little bit boring. You're going to know it's because there's no monsters at all. This jam is all about exploring the map and finding secrets and finding your way to the exit in very unique and different ways here. So without further ado, let's jump in and start exploring. Well, here we are in the first Explorer Jam 2 map. This is Temple of Achu. And this is by Bloughsburgh. And as everybody will know going into this, no kills. No monsters whatsoever. This is all about exploring, finding secrets. We got 30 secrets to find, so let's get to it here. I gotta say, immediately, let's see, shells will respawn here, health will respawn here as well. I gotta say, immediately looking at the style of this one, I love it. I love these like crazy reptile creatures that are hanging out over here. Jam shut for good. Okay, let's start making our way around. We need the silver key for that. Three more to go. Okay, two to go. There's one here. I already got this one. Yes, I did. Let's see. One, two, three. Is it going to be in the floor? Yeah, it's going to be hidden right there. There you go. Good eye. Already congratulating us. Good eye. Let's see, we got some water here. There is some sort of a rune in there, or a rune stone that we could be able to push later. I really wonder where these textures are from. These have to be from another set of maps, right? Okay, we hit that. Said, button seeker pillar discovered. Button seeker pillar discovered. Okay, so that did not open. Those are not buttons there. We do have armor up there. I wonder what the armor is for. There's got to be some weird areas we got to jump over to. Okay, so it looks like we got to hit. Are those things buttons over there? Yes, they are. Okay, so that's one. And let's do two. Inch our way around here. That opened up there, right? But how to get up there? Oh, hey there. Got some armor, we had a switch. That's a button there. How do we keep that thing out? It's like it's just sticking its tongue out at us or something. Alright, we got an interesting platforming section here. Whoop, totally messed that one up. Let's patrol around here, though. Okay, so I've already shot that. Go around this thing. There is a button on this side. There we go, we got that one. Just want to point out, only one secret out of the 30 so far. Not sure if we actually have to find them all. Oh, look at that. Doesn't look like that's the way to get in there. Not sure what that is at this moment anyway. Oh, there was a pillar up there. Oh, fell right through. It's not actually water. Okay. Alright, We start up here, go up this thing here. Whoop, gotta make that jump. There we go. Okay. Oh, hello. Hit this one. Hidden corner pillar discovered. So those are considered secrets there. So there's 30 pillars, really. Interesting way to go about doing this one, I think. That is not a secret there. There is something up there, though. Looks like that's how you would drop in. Whoa! Oh, I don't like that. There's another pillar up there to get. Ugh. So I was just thinking about it, though. I have to say, I kind of apologize to everybody watching this at the moment, because I feel like these Explore Jam maps, while, in my opinion, very fun to play, I don't imagine that these have to be, you know, super fun to watch, because it's a lot of just platform figuring out. You know, obviously with Quake stuff, you know, most normal Quake levels, you have monsters in you know, crazy traps and stuff like that to keep you interested. There's a flow, there's a linearity to follow. And with these Explore Jams, at least this one I can tell. Need the gold rune key for that. You know, it might be a little boring for people to watch. Okay, that takes you back to the main hub. Like I said, not boring for me to play. I think it's a lot of fun to try to find all these secrets and everything, but yeah, I think some people might find this to be a little boring. Oh, here we go. Here's a way to go. Another question mark, which means how do we get in there? But there is something to shoot there. Only one more to go. Haha. Found you. So really, I gotta find more buttons. That's what I gotta do. If I wanna get into places, I need to find more buttons. This place down here is just crazy. Watching all of these platforms do whatever the hell it is that they're doing is just nuts. Moving around so fast. Okay, this one does let me in. Okay, that's cool. This does too. Shortcut available at bottom. Good to know. Okay, we got some of these crazy jump puzzles here. You go up these ramps, they give you a little bit more jumping ability. Oh! Almost got it. This one might be... No, I was going to say that one might be the toughest one to get, but not so much. I need to somehow get over there, I think. Take this around. And then I can reach it from here, I'm assuming? No, still can't. Hmm. Maybe I need to drop onto it? Because I can see here. Oh, we almost made that. Is there a secret around here? No, but I do see that thing floating way up there. I don't know how... if that's counted in the secrets or not, but would be funny if it was. Be like, yeah, go ahead, try to get this one, guys. Oh, can he make it? There we go. Okay, we are up here. We are making some progress. And I need to drop down to where the button is. There it is. Oh, did I totally... Oh, my God. Can I really not reach this? Damn. Well, I tell you what I'm going to start doing here. I am going to start quick saving in these certain areas here. Because you just gotta.
Oh, not quite.
There we go. And I'm going to quick save right there so that way I can start back up here easily. And we are going to attempt to hit the jump from here. There we go. Stairs have been lowered. But what stairs? Oh, there's the key. Did not see that last time. Oh, here we go. Nice. There's one. So I don't know if it's important that we get all these pillars. But I do feel like as we're hitting certain ones, we're unlocking certain things throughout the map. I don't know if we really do just need to get the keys or what. Here we go. Oh, the jump is very strange. There we go. Oh, don't fall down. Okay. Another quick save for us. I want to take this up and around. What is over there? Anything? That doesn't look like it. Oh, there is one, like, way out there. How? Oh, I see. That does count as one. Oh. Oh, interesting. Okay. Void pillar discovered. Ooh. So we're at four. Four and only four. Okay, so how am I supposed to get over to that? Oh, there was a key over there the whole time. I don't know if it's actually something we need or want. Oh, boy. All right, first quick load. Yeah, there we go. Okay. We're making these jumps, right? No, we're not. I'm going to go and grab this. We did get a silver rune key, though, so that's important. To which we can now open this. Here we go. Okay. We're making progress. Jam shut for good. Oh, look at this. We're now below the main hub. That's interesting. Let's grab this bio suit. And I'm glad he's letting us know that the bio suit and everything else is going to end up respawning just in case we need it. Good to know. Okay, we hit the button that put everything in place, it looks like. That is not necessary. So there's something there. And what does that do? It just brings down an elevator? Okay. Yes, it does. Oh. Alright, so we are timed, it looks like there. We're not timed here, so maybe we can go get one of these pillars. This one that's a little bit lower. Okay. Oh, I was about to say, you can't be serious. I'm gonna give myself another save for this jump. This one looks like it's gonna be annoying. There we go, little shortcut. Boom. Hidden room pillar discovered. So if we continue this way, though, that will not get us up to that piece there. So we gotta hit this. And then run over. Those are brought up a bit. Okay, up we go. So now we can cut out some time here by jumping to these. Oh, did not make that. Okay, might as well wait at this point. And I thought we were doing so good too. All right, try it again. Okay, quick save there. Boom. There we go. Oh no! Just what I was like, man, I'm doing good with these jumps here. Nope. Up the stairs. Jump. Jump. Ugh, this is just not working out, is it? Gotta do my reload here. There we go. Do another quick save there really quick, just in case I can't get around this fast enough. Oh! Wow. I just made that. Boom. Speed demon pillar discovered. That's really cool. I like how all these are just tests. It's fun. I like that. Using all the strange quake physics, you know? Is there anything up here that I missed? I feel like there's gotta be something. Ah, yes. A gold key. Probably important. But those are not buttons. Okay, we got crates here, so we gotta do some crate jumping, it looks like. There we go, we got a gold key. But I am not done exploring down here. Let's head in this elevator. Let's see what's up this way. Oh, there was a pillar there. Did you see that? Let's see if we can do that again. Got it. Okay, so the real question is there a way to get on top of this thing and hit that button? It would not seem like there is. At least to me. But obviously there's gotta be a way. So this room looks like it's just kind of its own thing. There's not really much going on up here. There is something up there, it looks like, but not quite sure what it is. But... oh, yeah, I think I know what I gotta do here. Oh, no, I got trapped. I was hoping I could hit that button, bring it down, get on top of that. I can get on top of that via this thing, but I don't know how I would hit the button that way. Okay, so there's that. So I can get underneath it, but I can't run out of it quick enough when I'm up there. Let me give this one more shot here. And perhaps we shall move on. Can I hit it from the outside? Doesn't look to be the case. Oh, yeah, I just can't make it. So I can jump on top of it from there, but just, yeah. Nothing doing. That's okay, though. We did get the gold key, so that's important. What is over here in this corner? Haha! Saw some light. Figured I'd go check it out. Submerge pillar discovered! Alright, so I'm assuming we want to head back out, if that's even an option. Oh yeah, that's where I got the gold key. Alright, so I got the gold key. And we'll just give ourselves a quick save there, for the hell of it. Okay, we're on this thing now. Ooh, I got that key. So that's good. Gold key opens this thing. What on earth is happening here? I feel like I wasted my gold key. I really do. Or is that the only gold key door? It might have been. Oh man, there's a button on top of that too. Alright, well, okay, so below here is where that other elevator with the pillar was, so I know that, at least. Is this the exit, or is this just something? Walk into the darkness to exit. I don't think I want to exit yet. I want to sort of keep looking around. Discover 29 rune pillars to pass. Oh, boy. Oh, Bloughsburgh. You're killing me here because I really want to see what's behind this, but I don't know that I have the I don't know that I have the time today to actually find all of these pillars here. Oh, man. I'm very torn because I want to try to find them all. Did we ever get this one to open? We did. Not sure how, but we did. Fetid pillar discovered. Alright, to get up over there... Where did we go? Starting to get a little turned around here. Just because there's so much to do. We know that door is jammed shut. Wow, I can't believe I made that jump. I don't know if it's important at all. Because there's nothing in here. It doesn't seem like it was important at all, which is sad. Sad for me. What can you do? Yeah, there's a pillar right there, too. I don't even know how to get over to that one. Okay, we went through there. Did I not hit that button? I think I did fall off, didn't I? Alright, well, it's hit now. Alright, we fall back down here. So in here... Yeah, it was just this stuff here. Wasn't sure how to get up to that one. Unless maybe... Whoops. No, it kind of forces you up to this platform. I was hoping maybe I could angle it, but I can't. That's unfortunate. There is a pathway up there. Oh, there's a teleport I did not notice before. Back to top. Oh, I see. Okay, this takes you back up here. Which is fine, because now I feel like we can drop and get this button. Inch it over. Two more to go. Yeah? where are they? I do not know. Oh, I see one right there, so I'd have to take the platforms up again. Oh, I see. And that's how I'd get that one over there, is by those platforms. Okay. No! Really didn't want to do that, but that's okay. Yeah, there's no way I'm going to make that jump. Alright, so we hit that one. We drop here. Let's go across... Okay, we're on this one. Alright. So over there. One more to go. Where on earth is the last one? Nope, that's a drop. Not exactly what I was looking for, but what are you gonna do? Back to the top. Let's grab our health here. This room is crazy because there just seems to be so much going on in here. Oh, I missed that again. I really gotta start using my quick save, quick load in this one. And we'll start right now. Oh, that is not gonna work out. At all. How about this one? Nope, that's gonna knock me off. That's not gonna... Nope. Oop, that's not gonna do it. Okay, I'm on this one. Here comes three. Wow. This one's gonna take some practice. Alright, well, I gotta give this one more shot here. I would really like to find that last sword button. Not sure where it is. Okay, we don't want that one. There we go. We want... Oh my... Okay. I apologize, guys. Yeah, for two reasons. One is, I really don't want you to keep watching me try to jump on these platforms, because I don't feel like that's fun for anybody. And for two, I apologize that I'm going to be ending this without seeing whatever the super secret thing is from Bloughsburgh. I feel like I have failed in some way. But it's okay. It won't be the first failure. Right? Oh, there is something there, isn't there? If you're able to take... I see. Okay. Is it time, though? That's what I want to know. I bet it is. I'll give this one more shot here. Or not one. Yeah, it is timed. Wow, Bloughsburgh, you are unforgiving. I gotta say. That thing is timed? Oh, boy. Like, the other one was definitely a challenge, and this just seems like craziness to me. But that's okay. I think... whoa, wrong way. I think, unfortunately, with only 10 secrets found, we're going to have to end it there, because we're already about a half hour in here, and I really, really want to see what's beyond this, whatever it's going to be, but yeah, I don't think we're going to have the time to go through all this, because I feel like this would take me a good hour and a half to 2 hours to get through everything. It's not to say that I won't do it in my free time, but... what I will say is, you know, congratulations on this map, because there is a lot to this, and for anybody who wants to spend a lot of time in one explore map and just, you know, try to find every single secret and how to find every single pillar, I feel like this is going to be a lot of fun for you. It was definitely a lot of fun for me to find what I found, which really wasn't a whole lot. I found, you know, one-third of the pillars that you can actually find in here. And that's not to say that I actually didn't find more of them. Like, here's one right here. But finding the way up to them, now that, my friend, that's the tricky part. I think I might have found out how to get up to this one. And Bloughsburgh, I gotta say, pretty clever little trick here. Right? And we slowly ride this up. We'll get one more pillar for the road here. Hopefully. What's keeping me from... What is that? Alright, you know what? Forget it. I can't deal with the geometry stuff anymore. And there you have it. Yeah, there you go. Near a half hour, 26 minutes. And I don't think that I even saw this area here. I don't even know where this is, but there's red armor here. Well... Like I said, Bloughsburgh, congratulations on this map. I think it's really, really cool. I think it offers a lot of gameplay for someone who wants to spend that much time in one map and, you know, find all of the different pillars there. And I think using the secrets was a pretty clever way to, you know, add a whole new mechanic to the game. You don't see that a whole lot in Quake. You don't see secrets being used as a, you know, a mode of giving somebody... some sort of a prize at the end, you know, and a lot of times you don't see a lot of map authors use secrets as a ways to, you know, getting to the end of a map in any way, shape, or form. But, of course, the Explorer Jam is going to be a little bit more unique as it is anyway, but just wanted to say, you know, congrats on this, because I think it's a really cool attempt at an Explorer map, and I think it's very successful in that way, especially giving someone the option to exit with what they have already. And then giving them the option, like, hey, there is this tantalizing secret over here if you find a few more pillars. So, yeah, like I said, great job on this one. I enjoyed it. All right, we are now in the second Explorer Jam 2 map. It doesn't look like this one has a title, but this is by Naitelveni. Looks like he's got quite a map here for us to check out. We got a pent up there. First thing we see as we get in, there are no secrets, there are no kills. Is this instant death? No. It's just, you do get hurt though, so let's check out what we got here. Alright, so nothing in there. There are some teleporters up there though. We got some lava, there's a bunch of keys in there. We need the gold key for that room. We're in the water. It's a very interesting landscape job here with this one. Solve the puzzle, then protect yourself. What? Oh boy. Look down, it's the puzzle, solve it. Okay. Seems like you are not ready. I would agree, I am definitely not ready. It ports us back out over here. So how do we find the solution to that puzzle? Before I enter that, I wanted to say this very interesting approach to the level here with the atmosphere and the design. Big hills all over the place. I'm assuming this is supposed to be white sand or snow. I can only gather that the tile sets used in this Explorer Jam are all from the Arcane Dimensions stuff that we... Oh, walk into the corner. Okay, shoot up at the sky and pray. Praying. Is that it? Okay. So now I'm screwed? Now I can't get up there? But I think that's what Bloughsburgh's map, the first one that I played, I think that's what was going on with his too. I think the textures were actually from the Arcane Dimensions. It's a map that I haven't been able to play through yet for the show. The darkest corner has a red light. It's C. Oh, it calls you. Okay, it's a bit long, so it didn't show up on the screen completely, so I couldn't read it all. But there's a red light in the dark corner, it says. Did not see a red light. Okay, that elevator did come back down, so we can give that a shot again. Okay, I'm shooting at the sky. What's supposed to happen? There we go. Okay, now I'm going to wait here patiently. And yeah, I don't think that these textures are from Arcane Dimensions. What did it say? Your superstition shall be rewarded. Okay, great. But these white textures, they haven't been used a whole lot, but I do know that they are used for one of the maps that we played through in the Arcane Dimensions playthroughs. So, very nice tile set. When I was playing through that other map, I definitely enjoyed playing through it, having a whole different look. Okay, so we got the pent, so now... Okay, we got the gold key. We're supposed to be doing something else here? Or is this just a maze? Whoop. Am I just trapped? Okay. I tell you what, we're gonna try this one more time here. I'm going to do a quick save as soon as I get that pent and I run into the lava, because I know I got to get that gold key. There we go. We got to get that gold key and get out of that maze somehow. Not sure where we're supposed to go, but we'll find out. Yeah, I really got to get back to the Arcane Dimensions pack. I'm about due to do the part 3 for that. You already did two parts. There's plenty more maps to play through. Alright. I'm gonna do a quick save there. Okay, we grabbed it. Yes, yes, yes. Okay, we want that. It blocks us. Am I going the wrong way? Because I'm blocked from going everywhere here. I'm just going to immediately jump back in here and try it again. He says solve the puzzle, so we get the pent. I'm assuming we got to go through the right area, right? Oh, I see. Okay, so solving the puzzle is looking down. Your luck ends here, so we're going to die here. So we got to reload. Yeah, we're completely walled in. So we definitely want to get the gold key, but we got to go through the right. So we go through the middle. There's another pent. There's armor. But that locks us in. Okay, well, I can say immediately that the trial and error of this is not super duper fun. There's another pent. And of course you'd solve the puzzle in a certain way to get things done the right way, and I am trapped again. Great, great, great. Okay, I know at least so far we go through here. We gotta go in here. We gotta grab this. Go through here? Nope, because... Okay, that's the way I went before. So we... reload. Again. Alright. Let's grab this. Let's do another quick save there, because we grabbed a fresh pent. Alright. We went through there before. So this middle one, maybe? No, I'm an idiot. This one. Here we go. Okay, we're making progress. So through here. Your luck runs short, traveler. Reload again. Yes, it was this one. Okay. Alright, so last time I went straight across. I'm gonna go for this one. Greed is punishable by death. Come on, dude, give me a break here, huh? We went to this far one, right? Okay, we went that way. It was punishable by death. Hey, we made it! Cool. Now we can open this door. Oh, okay, and that's the whole level. So once you figure out that puzzle, you are good to go. So, yeah, I'm not super duper thrilled by this one, unfortunately. I mean, I don't think it's awful, but it feels like there was a lot of stuff created in this. Like, you see the pillars and you see teleporters and everything all over the place, and you feel like there's going to be a lot more to this map than meets the eye, but really, the whole puzzle is figuring out how to get the pent in the first place, and then you're sort of, you know, guessing your way through which, you know, hallway you're supposed to go through the lava-infested area. So, you know, it's all right, but I don't know that this is one that I would ever come back to play again. I'm never a big fan of trial and error gameplay, and that's what this seemed like it was. I'm sure that that little puzzle that when you first go through the teleporter might give you some sort of a clue as to, you know, where the end of this, you know, maze is, but if it did, I really have no idea what it was supposed to be. So maybe that's just me, maybe that's on me, I don't know, but, the elevator in the corner where you gotta shoot at the sky or whatever, I don't know, that seems a bit strange too. I don't know, maybe it would have been wise to have like a teleporter on the ground somewhere that takes you up to where the pent is, and then you have to do like a platforming puzzle to get over to it, or, you know, shoot a series of buttons that raises stairs that takes you up to it. I don't know, something of that nature. But of course, in a true explorer jam, you do have to explore and find your way to, you know, get through this. So in that, it was successful. But I don't know. This one was okay, but maybe it just needed to be explored a bit more. Huh? You get it? Explored? I don't know. But Naitelveni, I definitely look forward to seeing what you're going to do next here. Alright, so here we are in Newhouse's map, and it let us know that we got a rune, and we are to choose our skill. So we have practice, harder, and pro. So I guess we should probably start with practice first. And I don't know if this is actually going to, take us back to the beginning or what, but... Chamber of Elements. Element of Memory, Element of Dream... Element of Time. Okay, so there's several elements. We got a teleporter over here. Let's check it out. Path of Memory. Well, one thing I could say, Newhouse, immediately is that this one is definitely spacey feeling. This feels like 2001 Space Odyssey, like monolith feeling, you know what I mean? Not quite the teleport. We didn't get teleported at all. We got these crazy all-seeing eyes just, like, waiting around here for us. Whoa, I thought I was going to die right there. So much for practice, right? Up there, okay. We're doing this so far, we're doing okay. Up we go. Remember, save your memories. Can you see the difference? Well, I'm going to quick save just in case I didn't. Up we go. Ooh, that's not good. And that will take us to a slow death. I'm sorry. Not a slow death at all. A very quick death. I'm sorry, was I supposed to keep in mind that there's some sort of a pattern to where we're supposed to go here? Okay, that's right. That's up, that's up. Oh no, that's a fall. There is something in there, though. So, again, did I totally miss what I was supposed to be looking at to memorize? Or this is literally just a memory game? Take us over again. Nope, that's a fall as well. Can we make this jump? No, we can't. Alright, there, there, there. Here. Is it a color thing? Are these brown as well? Okay, it is sort of a color thing, you could tell. Interesting. Alright, well, we made it through that, so that's cool. There are actually 6 secrets to find in this practice map, too. Whoa! Teleporter there. Teleporter there. And one there. So blue, red, and green... You want to go red, I guess? That's incorrect. How about green? That is also incorrect. How about blue? We have arrived somewhere else. Okay, we went through blue before, right? And that spit us into some strange land here. With platforming. Let's go to shot. Do we want to fall in this one? Or is this going to start us over? I knew it. I knew it would start us over. Oh, missed the drop. Okay, into the blue again. Alright. This time we're going to get up, and we're going to quick save. Alright. Quick saved. So I gotta say, Newhouse, you have definitely been creating a lot of maps lately. All these map jams seem to feature you, which is... pretty nuts, in my opinion. We're going to keep going blue here, because it seems to be our lucky color. blue again, I guess. Here we are. And we got the gold key. But yeah, I don't think that's a bad thing at all. I think it's great that you're cranking out all these maps. It's really cool. It's fun to see mappers sort of, you know, evolve as they keep going. And the one thing I can say, oh, that didn't work out. The one thing I could definitely say about Newhouse's maps here is that with every new one that comes out, there seems to be something about it that, is an improvement over what he was doing before. Okay, that's too far of a jump. That jump over there looks like I can make it somehow. I gotta jump at the very last minute, though. No. That was, it felt very close, though. Nope, not quite. Maybe I gotta do the old... Wow, even that didn't make it. I was gonna say, maybe I gotta do the whole strafe jumping thing. Wow, can't make it. That's okay. Whatevs. Let's go down here and replenish the old health. Okay, we did not go this way yet. Path of Time. Okay, so we have we had limited amount of time to do everything we're doing there. So we got three buttons that all seem to do different things. So we gotta go, go, go. Alright. That one. This one. This one. Get me up. Hey, there we go. That wasn't too bad. But this one might be crazier. Oh yeah, didn't piece that one together in my head. That's for sure. Oh, make that, yeah. These timing ones are satisfying. Once you hit them, once you're able to make that jump, that feels satisfying. It really does. Am I supposed to go here? Oh yeah, I guess so. Okay. I can do that. I'll give myself another quick save, because why not? Be generous with those during this map jam. Oh, there's a silver key. Excellent. Alright, so we got both keys. So now what? Now we can enter through the red gook over here. Is that it? You must collect time and memory. And we did. Okay, cool. So that was the practice map, right? Okay, and this that takes us right back to regular old Quake here. So let's reload Newhouse's map and see if we can check out the medium version. Alright, back in Newhouse's map. We got timing and jump in practice, harder, and pro like we did before. Let's check out harder here. And, okay, so this is the same map, you just have skill difficulty selections, which is kind of cool. So, I guess we'll see. Let's start with the time one, because I seem to breeze through that one pretty quick. I just want to see what's different really quick here. If there really is all that... You know, anything that is that much different. So, this one, up. Okay, so times are shorter. That I can speak to right now. You found an element of life. Don't know what the element of life is, but I found one. Yeah, so from what I could tell, it looks like that's what's going on with these, is that they're kind of giving you shorter time and making it a little bit more challenging for you to deal with here. But having just played the other one, to me it doesn't seem to be all that difficult. though things are moving a bit quicker. You notice these platforms are sort of racing each other, moving a bit quicker than they were before. Grab that silver key. And we'll go through this. Yeah, before we do, let's go ahead and get them, get some health there, and we'll go into the next area. And up the stairs we go. So, okay, yeah, so this is all the same stuff, just with different speeds. That's interesting. That's a cool approach to it, I think. Alright. Now the other question is, will it be the same? Yeah, it looks like it's the same puzzle here. You know, it would have been cool if they would have made the memory area, like, way harder. Or rather, if Newhouse would have made this memory area harder. And in that, you know, maybe made it a lot bigger. Maybe platforms only raise up for a certain amount of time or something. I don't know. Might have been something cool to try out. Alright, we know we gotta do blue. Jump up here. Over here to blue. Blue. Do a quick save just in case my brain decides to go on me again here. Nope, we made it. Grab that. Grab the gold key. Well, look at that. Now I'm a pro. That only took me 3 minutes 20 seconds. Well, actually, I'm sorry. I take that back. I'm not a pro, but I can get finish this on a harder difficulty. So, yeah, Newhouse. This was a lot of fun, actually. I really like this one. I almost wish that there was, like, maybe one more corridor to explore, you know? But as it is with a map jam, you know, you only have so much time to actually create stuff like this. But I thought this one was a lot of fun. I love the idea of, like, you know, you can challenge yourself by doing, you know, harder puzzles as it goes on or whatever. Or you could just play through the practice round, you know, and kind of get the same idea there. So I thought that this was, like I said, a lot of fun. This felt, in my opinion, more like the Explorer Jam 1 pack that came out last year that I enjoyed quite a bit. I feel like this one would have fit in perfectly with those two maps because it just has that ease of use and breezy feel of a map, you know. It's challenging, but it's not, you know, that frustrating feeling when it comes to challenging. It's like, to me, it's sort of like playing Portal, you know. If you play through Portal and Portal 2, I love the puzzles in that because, you know, none of those puzzles are ever going to make you so frustrated that you are going to stop playing the game. They might take you a few tries. They might make you, you know, save and quit for a little bit and come back to it to try later. But none of them are ever going to, like, you know, deter you from coming back and playing the rest of the game, which I feel like, you know, this map, if it were lumped in with the first two in Explorer Jam 1, it would have been a perfect fit and a perfect, you know, pack of maps to all play, you know, one after the other and just have a really good time with. So good job on this one. I liked it. Well, here we are in Pulsar's map. Let's see. We have 6 secrets to find. Obviously no kills. This one is called Sahil. We'll just say that for now on. Welcome, Explorer. Begin your journey. All right. Let's begin our journey then. We got a button. Oh, and it raises the gate. Well, I can say right off the bat that Pulsar's has, I feel like, the most welcoming beginning. You actually hit a button and it opens a gate and says, oh, by the way, there's a lot of lava down there. Be careful. Let's hit this button here. Oh, okay. So we got a platform over here now. Do not fall in the lava. Nothing to do here. But we will quick save. Okay, we got a lift right there. Oh! And see, that's why we quick save. Okay, no secret under the stairs. Oh, the darkness hides secrets. Like what? It says the darkness hides secrets, and then what did it do? I heard something open. What am I missing? What can I see? Oh well. Moving up. Press the button. Okay, here's the button. Oh, I see what you're doing to me here. How do we make it through that? Whoa, super close there. Oh, just made it. Just squeaked by. This is going to be another interesting jump here. There we go. Okay. Bars have been opened below. Down there? Yeah, and then we can just drop, which is nice. Okay, yep. So, there's the lift that we couldn't get to. There's those... Oh! Did you just see that? Pulsar, what are you trying to do to us here? Lift activated. Oh, I gotta go back through again? Jeez. Oh, there was a way to go there. So those bars are open, and we could take the lift there if we need to. Good to know. And what is over here? Anything? There's a non-functioning torch. Not sure if that's important or not. Is this a jumping thing? Do I have to jump to that and then over to there? It would sure seem like it, wouldn't it? That's a Quake Ranger's head or something up on a... jibbed up there. That's pretty wild. Now, the one thing I haven't mentioned much about in Pulsar's map here is just the look of it. I love the old-school Quake-feeling castle look here. This map feels like it would have fit right in with old id maps in the feeling here. And I adore that. And part of that, you know, I could see this map being like a secret map in the campaign itself, you know? That would be super duper fun if it would have included a map, you know, like one of these puzzle maps here to include as a secret. That would have been really cool. Oh no, that torch kept me from... Alright. There's the jump. Okay, we gotta avoid the torch. There we go. Made the jump. Let's give ourselves another save because we made it there. That's where we started from. But yeah, how cool would it have been if it included like a weird map like that? I know they're, you know, they're more mostly about like wanting to make sure people were into killing monsters and that felt good, which is always important. But would have been so cool if they changed it up just a little bit. Oh man. Oh shit. This might be the only room that I'm not super fond of. And I can't jump up on it that way, can I? The thing that sucks is that these things are gonna hit me no matter what. Oh, they're not. Okay. Ooh. I'm gonna get hit a couple times, but running out? Okay. Yeesh. Wind tunnel. There we go. So I guess what I'm saying, though, is to me... I feel like that's a big compliment, because even though map design, I feel like, I would say, in this day and age, is a lot different than it was, you know, back when, that I really admire a map that... Oh, don't squish me. Okay, we made it. I really admire the maps that try to recreate how old Quake maps felt. And this map does wonders with that, I feel. And it's part of the reason why I always have a great time playing those Retro Jam maps when they come out. Everyone usually does such a great job of recreating... Oh, almost got it. Everyone always does such a great job of trying to recreate that feeling with those maps, and they're always a ton of fun for me to play. This jump is going to be kind of a bitch for me, isn't it? I gotta make it to that, and then probably jump to that one? Oh, totally messed that one up. Maybe I can make it to that middle one. No, I can't. Okay. I gotta get better at jumping, like, right at the last second. Like that. Okay. Quick save that. This jump is gonna be annoying. Isn't it? Oh, and I fell off. Get used to seeing that, people. Oh no, I made it! Look at that. Look at that. There are more to go. Oh. So he included some shooty buttons. And that was the very first one I actually saw. Oh man, look at that. This whole piece of the castle is just draining, falling down into the lava. I love that. That is so cool. So anyway, I'm sorry, yeah. Very long-winded talking about, like, you know, maps looking retrofied for Quake. So I apologize for that. But basically, I'm just trying to say I really enjoy this aesthetic, and I think it's great that there's at least one map included in this pack that keeps with the Quake look. And of course, not that I dislike, you know, other tile sets and textures and stuff like that. I love anything anybody's going to make for Quake, really. Oh man, I don't know how I made that jump, but I did. Time for a quick save. Oh, but we can't fit through there. Okay. Oh, terrible jump. Okay, there's that. So I'm here, but where the hell am I supposed to go now? Oh, boy. To me, it looks like I could fit through there, but I can't. Lots of quick loading here. Sorry, guys. Just how it has to be. Oh, I almost made it. Terrible jump. Well, I'm not making any of these. I gotta get around there, it would seem. Am I not doing it right? Maybe I'm not. Maybe I gotta get up on that ledge there. Oh, let me see this again. Yeah, I'm doing this wrong. Okay, I gotta get back over here. Well, poop. Ew. Ugh. Oh my god. I'm gonna do that, what, 7 times in a row now? Okay. Okay, we made that. Alright, great. Don't fall off. So now I gotta make this jump. Yep, there we go. And then we gotta get to the top here. Made that. Okay, great. Now I can make it over here. That was what we needed to do the whole time. And we did. We're looking pretty good here, I would say. Oh man, we got platforms to get to. Oh! That was a bit early, wasn't it? Considering we actually got to jump to this one first. Oh boy. This is not working out for me at all. Oh! Death all... Oh my god! Death all, all over for me. Okay, let's get to this piece. Oh, Lord. Are you serious? Quick save. Hey, we made it. Okay, so this is gonna go top of that, and I gotta race that thing down. There we go. That's good. I like that. Ooh, maybe I did the... Did I do the wrong thing? Where am I going here? Okay, we'll do a quick save there, because I'm not quite sure where I'm supposed to be going. Do I jump onto that? Or no, I jump onto the ledge up here, right? Yes. There it is. Okay. More crate jumping. And to the torch. No. Oh, didn't want to do that. Oh, but we're okay. We did. Thought we were going to fall to the lava, but we did not. Oh, boy. There we go. Oh, just missed it. Just missed it again. I'm sure a lot of you are watching this like, this guy quick saving, what is this crap? But I really don't see another way that you'd be able to get through a lot of these maps without doing it. Well done, Explorer. Proceed to the final room. The way to the beginning opens. Okay. And other realms. Oh, okay. There you go. That is the end of that one. So Pulsar, I gotta say, I know I went on a huge rant there about the atmosphere and the usage of, the Quake tile set, making it look like, you know, something that it did here. But I gotta say, other than that, regardless of all that, I think this might be my favorite in the pack so far, given I got one more map to play through, but this might be my favorite. This one is great. This one... not only feels like you're exploring, but you're hitting buttons and you're riding platforms, and just the sheer variety of things that you get to do in this map jam, and the I would say also in the amount of space that it takes up too. You figure you're looking at the start point right here on the left, right? So when that gate opens, that's the very start there, and you drop down to where this button is, and then your start. So you're basically doing a circle around. You start there, and then you jump to the sort of castle thing in the corner there, then the one on this corner, then the one that's on the very right side here, and then the next one that's in the next corner, and you're basically just doing a circle around to get to the exit. So the amount of stuff that you do in this level to get to the exit within the time that you're given, within the confines that you're given and everything, you know, it's just, to me, feels like a great accomplishment. So it looks great. There's a lot of variety to it. There's a lot of cool stuff to do. I did not find even one of the six secrets, so there's plenty of secrets to find in this one if you're looking for them. But this is just one that I really, really enjoyed. It's very similar to Newhouse's map, where I feel like it would fit in great with the first Explorer Jam pack, because it just, you're just laying back. You're not getting frustrated. You're just like retrying things and trying to figure out what is the best way to jump, you know, through these crates to get to the next area, you know? What is the best way to get through these traps, you know? And it just feels really good, and it's a lot of fun. So I gotta say, Pulsar, great, great work on this one. Like I said, I think it might be my favorite in the pack. We got one more map to play through, but I think it might be. So anyways, great job. And we are in the last map now. This is by Topher. Was not given a name, but he did tell us welcome, so... that's always a plus, right? What happens if we jump off? We die here? Oh no, we just run around here. I was thinking it was going to restart us, but it didn't. Oh boy, okay. So... we're just kind of stuck down here, huh? We're in a box, right? Oh, wow. Huh. We're just stuck down here. Okay. So I just figured we had to restart the map because I fell down and didn't realize that there was no... okay, this arch selects easy skill, and this is normal. All right, so we'll go with normal, right? Oh, it dropped us down. We got to kill ourselves again. Okay. I understand the whole, like, this is easy jump in thing, and then this is normal, use this thing. And you got to do, like, kind of a silly jump to get over to it. But I don't think it was super necessary to do that in the difficulty selection area. All right. Zero secrets, zero kills to find. Let's see what we can do here. And I'm going to quick save just in case, because I don't know if dropping down will actually kill us in this one or not. But all right, we got a lot of weird pillar things to follow here. All right, so we got to do like kind of a crazy jump. How are we going to angle it to get up to that? I feel like I'm getting close, but not quite close enough. Oh, it does. Okay, good. It does teleport you. I feel like the start map ought to do that too. All right. Obviously, we got to hit that ramp and jump at a certain point and make it up to that thing. And then there's a platform there where we'll jump to get up to where the key is. And then the key's going to open up that thing and take us to the exit. So the hardest part about this is getting this jump right here, it looks like. Oh, wow. I felt like I almost got it. Try it again. See, the problem is that once you get going in a certain direction so fast, it's like hard to turn around and, you know, reappropriate the speed to get up to the place where you need to go. Wow, I may not be good enough for this. I may not be able to do this one. I'm not quite sure what I'm doing wrong. Right? Or am I supposed to just get to the top? No, I can't do that. That's not going to work. See, I feel like I'm getting up there. I just cannot get him to change his speed at all. Oh, that's just jumping right off. What the fuck? I was like, where did I land? But I'm like, here's that. I just jumped over here. That's why I was like, where am I? Am I missing something here? Is there some invisible thing I can jump onto over here or something? Does not look to be the case. All right, well, I have tried this jump several times. And I don't know if you guys out there are able to get this one easier than I can, but I cannot get this. Oh, maybe that's it. Maybe you have to strafe up it and then strafe onto the platform. Is that how this works? Oh my, it felt like I had it. Oh. Okay, so you gotta keep the momentum going with the way that you're strafing. That's the thing. Okay. Alright, a few more tries. I feel like I'm getting close to figuring this out. Oh, jeez, I got it. I don't know how, but I actually got that. Quick save that for damn sure. Wow. I don't want to have to try that one again. Okay, up here. Checkpoint reached. Okay, good. Well, I'm going to quick save just in case. How do you feel about that? Really like these strafing jumps, huh? Okay, yeah, it does checkpoint. That's good. Oh, jeez. I got to really turn around. Okay. Nope, not quite. Oh, I did something. Did you see this? I landed on top of where the key is. Can I get the key from here? Or do I have to get up there to activate where I gotta go? I'm not really sure. Can I drop and get the key? No. No, I cannot. I feel like I gotta get up in that. Oh, I almost had it. I could feel it. Oh! I feel like I almost had it again. Okay, I'm back up on the key thing. But unfortunately, I cannot jump from there and actually reach that. Maybe this is where I'm supposed to go. Maybe I'm supposed to, like, somehow jump and sidestep that thing. But it doesn't seem right to me. I don't think that is what you're supposed to do. I think I am supposed to get up on that thing somehow. Whoops. Oh my god, I felt like I had it right there. Nope, not this time. Okay, I know what I'm doing wrong here. I am pushing forward too much, and it's bringing me over there, which is, in hindsight... Oh, I made it. Okay. Another quick save. All right, so where am I supposed to go from here? Oh, you got another jump for me? No. Shit. Quick load. We're now quick loading. Okay, we made that jump. Another quick save. Okay, we're doing another one here. Oh, wow. Where's the checkpoint at? Wow. So I think that's a big problem. These jumps right here are so hard, you need to checkpoint every single one you get up to, at least in my opinion. Luckily, we have the old quick load, quick save system. Wow, that's not going to work. That's not going to work either. Oh, I thought I had it right there. Hey, second checkpoint. That one I didn't even know how I got to it, but I did. Oop, it moved. Okay, we made that one. That thing is moving at the speed of light. Cage is open. We got the key. We open the door. Is that the exit? Oh, you got more jumping. Okay. Interesting. There's nowhere to go from here, right? He does one final jump, and then the end. So there you go. Wow. That one was crazy. Holy. So... that one might be the most frustrating of the group. I gotta say, I don't think it's bad. You know, it's just a lot of crazy weird trick jumping there. If that's what you're into with Quake, great. For me, that's just not my style. But again, I don't think it's a bad map. I gotta say, I really love this green skybox here. But yeah, the trick jumping and stuff like that is just not for me. Like, a little bit of trick jumping, like if you want to do the speed, you know, ramp jumps and stuff up to buttons and stuff like Bloughsburgh did in the first map, I'm okay with that. But doing these crazy strafe jumpings up, I mean, what I have to say about them is that I think they're super interesting. I think it's cool that you can actually accomplish them in Quake. It's definitely some really crazy weird physics stuff. But I gotta say, when you create this map, I don't know how you come to the conclusion that people can make these jumps. Maybe you're just that much better of a trick jumper than maybe I am. I don't know. I was able to actually make these, which I was surprised at myself at. So the one thing I can definitely applaud this map for is, like, for helping me realize that I can actually do some tricks like that there. So, but... like I said, nonetheless, I don't want to harp on it or be negative about it, because it is a cool map, and I think it is a cool approach to the whole Explore Jam thing. Just not really my speed, I guess. But there you have it, everybody. That is the Explore Jam 2. I think that everybody did a great job, everybody included. Even if I wasn't a big fan of your map, please do not get discouraged, because I know that you're going to do some great things going forward. And, you know, the Explore Jam pack, I got to say, is a very, very... acquired taste, and it not only is it acquired taste, but I feel like there's sort of a perfect storm that goes into making a good one of these maps. You may have an idea that on paper just sounds awesome, but then when you put it, you know, together for the map jam, of which you already have a limited amount of time to put a map together for, you know, it may not always come together exactly as you may have thought. So, like I said, I apologize to anybody if any of my comments sound negative about your map, because I'm really not trying to be negative about it. A lot of times, I just want to say that, you know, a certain map just isn't my speed and it doesn't fit with the kind of map that I like. But what's great about the mapping community is that everybody creates different types of maps that different people are going to like. My preference usually more stems towards, like, older maps, maps that were released, you know, the 96, 97 era, which is why this whole show was created in the first place. Creating nowadays is completely different from the maps that were released, you know, 20 years ago. But again, just wanted to point out, please don't get discouraged. Please keep making maps, because we need you around. We need fresh blood, and we need everybody here, whether you're new or old, to keep making these great maps, because they're a lot of fun to play. And regardless of what I may have said, I really enjoyed my time playing through this map pack. So again, great job, everybody. Thank you for your maps, and I will see you all next time on the Quake Grave.
Be sure to check out all of my other Quake Grave episodes, or jump into the GGRC show that I've been doing. I think you'll like it.